This is for all you one-celled organisms out there. Keeping it real. Hizzle in the house. Mm-hmm. Word. Para what? Para who? Para me. C-I-U-M. Para what? Para who? Para me. C-I-U-M. I want to tell you about a one-celled thing that lives in water and likes to swim. It don't got no eyes or a heart, but it does got other special parts. We got a brain that tells us what to do, but a parent doesn't have just one, but two. Of all nuclei, one's large, one's small, there is one difference, and that is all. The large one controls the whole entire cell, except for moving. Ain't that swell? The small nucleus has this job, making sure the cell is not acting like a bob. The cilia are tiny little hairs moving back and forth with little care. To make the paramecium move and push food into the oral groove. The groove is where the food goes in. It's an opening that is very thin. The food vacuole is the very next stop where the stuff it eats gets processed and shot. Once the paramecium has fed, there is nasty waste it has to shed. The anal pore gets this job done so the paramecium can have lots of fun. Cell membrane is the next part that protects this thing from the very start. If it gets a hole or a tear, the paramecium will explode into thin air. Another part to help it survive pushes extra water out all the time. Without these vesicles, this water wouldn't stop coming in and the paramecium would pop. Finally, there's a gel that holds stuff in. This is called the cytoplasm. Now that you know all the parts, let's take it home with the chorus from the start. Para who? Para what? Para me, C-I-U-M. 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 That's the one-cell protist, paramecium. Don't you forget, single cell can live on its own. It's an organism. Mm-hmm. What?